Hello students, today we will discuss working of human heart. In my previous video, I have explained the structure of human heart to you, in which we will discuss all four chambers, septum, valves, arteries and veins. Today we will discuss that how this human heart works. And working of human heart is best described as cardiac cycle. And if we define this, it is defined as the continuous relaxation, or it is also called as diastole. Please note down, students, this is a new term for you. And contraction, that is systole of the heart, determines cardiac cycle. That means cardiac cycle completed when continuous relaxation, that is diastole, and contraction, that is systole, takes place. It lasts for about, that means this whole cardiac cycle will complete it in 0.8 seconds. That means it will take fraction of second time, and it is completed in three steps. Three steps are there, students. That is, first is both artery and ventricles relax. That means in that case, all the four chambers relaxed. Second point is both atria contracts. Third point is both ventricles contracts. Now take a look of the human heart, which we have explained in the previous video also. I will brief you how cardiac cycle will take place in the human heart. See, first point is, as I have told you, when all the four chambers are in the relaxed phase, that means they are in the diastole phase. When both lower chambers are in the relaxed phase, in that phase, blood will enter into the upper chambers, right? Then that means after the first step, when all the four chambers are relaxed, at this time, heart is filled with the blood. Okay, now second step of the cardiac cycle is both the upper chambers, these two chambers, right auricle and left auricle, contracts and it squeezes all its blood downwards into the left ventricle from the left auricle, and from the right auricle it drains into the right ventricle, right? That means second point is clear to you, that is both upper chambers contract. Now, where is the blood? Now, where is the blood filled? Which chamber is filled with the blood fully? That is the two ventricles. Now, fully filled with the blood. Now, the third step, students, when both the lower chambers, right ventricle and left ventricle, filled with the blood. Now, in the third step, these two chambers contract and drain their blood into the respective arteries. That means from the left ventricle, blood will enter into the aorta, which is the largest artery of the body, and from the left right ventricle into the pulmonary artery, right? That means three steps are there, students. That is, first step is all four chambers relaxed. Second step is both upper chambers contract. Third step is both downward chambers, ventricles, both ventricles contract. That means this again, the cycle will restart with the relaxation of all four chambers. And again upper chambers contract and again lower chambers contract. This cycle will go on and go on and go on. That means we will describe first step one. That is both atria and ventricles relax. And it is also called as I have told you, relaxation is also meant as diastole. That's why it is also called as joint diastole. That means at this phase, all the four chambers relax. That's why it is called as diastole phase. Two important points are there, students. Two points you have to write in this. First is, what happens when the artery and ventricles relaxed? At this time, deoxygenated blood from larger veins, that is vena cava, that pour into the deoxygenated blood from large veins, pour into the right auricle. You can see in the structure of the human heart, right? And oxygenated blood, that is coming from the pulmonary vein, pour into the left auricle or left atrium. That's it. In this type of flowchart, you can write your answer. Second step is, students, when both atria contracts, contract is also called a systole. That's why it is also called as joint systole. This is the systolic phase of the cardiac cycle. In this phase, deoxygenated blood, in the right side we can say deoxygenated blood from right auricle, which entered in the previous step. Right auricle is full of blood now. Therefore, this deoxygenated blood from right auricle poured into the downward chamber, that is right ventricle. And when we talk about left side, oxygenated blood which is coming in the, which is present in the left auricle, it now contracts. When left auricle contracts, then it pours its blood into the respective lower chamber, that is left ventricle. Right, students? Step 3 is very simple, that is both ventricles contract. This is also systolic phase, that's why both ventricles contract, that's why it is also called as joint systolic phase. And at this, or we can say how it is different from the second step, that is it is joint ventricular systolic phase, we can specify it, right? Now in the right side, when right ventricle is full of blood now, so after the contraction of this right ventricle, deoxygenated blood pour into the pulmonary artery, right? Pulmonary artery, which takes the blood to the lungs for the purification of blood. Next is oxygenated blood in the left side. From left ventricle, it pour down into the dorsal aorta, which is the largest artery of the body, and it takes blood to the all over the body parts except lungs, right? Now these are the three steps, step 1, 2, 3 of the cardiac cycle, and you can write in a simple way like this. Okay, now I will explain you about the heartbeat. Heartbeat is made up of two sounds, lung and duct sound. Rate of heartbeat, as you know, in adult human being, it is 70 to 72 times per minute. As I have written here, you can see that heartbeat consists of two sounds. First sound is lub sound and second sound is dub sound. Now, we have to understand with the help of the structure of the human heart that when and how these sounds are developed. Let's look, take a look of the human heart. In this, you can see when ventricles are full of blood, or filled with the blood. At the time of contraction of these ventricles, what will happen? At the time of contraction of these ventricles, to prevent the backflow of blood from ventricle to the upper chamber, AV valves play an important role. These AV valves shut down immediately. So, at that time, students, at the time of closure of these AV valves, the first sound created, which is called as lub sound, that is created at the time of closure of AV valves. Now second sound. Second sound is heard as dub sound. Whenever blood enters into the respective arteries from the ventricles, that is from left ventricle into the aorta and from right ventricle into the pulmonary artery. Now blood enters into these respective arteries, and there are the second type of valves, which are called as semilunar valves, play an important role here, shut down immediately to prevent this flow of blood into the respective lower chambers or ventricles. So at that time, at the closing time of semilunar valves, a second sound is developed, which is called as dub sound. That's why I have written that it is created at the time of closure of SL valves. Okay, students, now this is all about heartbeat. Next, we will study about the double circulatory system. Students, let us discuss double circulatory system in human beings. A circulatory system in which the blood travels twice through the heart is called as double circulation. In human beings, as we have four chambered heart, blood from the heart first travel to the body organs and then back to the heart, and again from the heart to the lungs and then again back to the heart. Therefore, it is showing double circulatory system. But in animals such as in fishes, which are two chambered heart, which are having two chambered heart, there are gills for the exchange of gases. So blood travels from their heart into the gills and again from the gills back to the heart. Therefore, this is a single circulation, single cycle in fishes. Blood circulation is completed in single cycle. That's why these animals are showing the single circulatory system, single circulation of blood in their body. That's why, students, please note down, there is your homework. Please note down your homework that you have to find out the differences between the single circulation and the double circulation. Right? Now, back to the double circulatory system. This is the schematic diagram which I have drawn. In the schematic diagram, you can see that this is the heart, body tissues are here, and these are showing as lungs. In this, double circulatory system is combination of two circulations. First is systemic circulation and second is pulmonary circulation here. So let us take a look of the systemic circulation. In systemic circulation, students, blood when they present in the left ventricle, and at the time of contraction of this left ventricle muscles, when left ventricle contracts, blood flows from the left ventricle to the body tissues through the largest artery of the body called as aorta. That's why you have to show flow of blood with the help of arrows. When blood enter into the body tissues or cells utilize this oxygen for their respiration to generate energy and also release carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide again combined with the hemoglobin, and also we can say 70% of the carbon dioxide is dissolved in the form of plasma, and this carbon dioxide enter into this blood vessel known as vena cava. Vena cava take this blood to the right auricle of the heart. Now you have to understand, and you have remembered in the structure of the heart, I have told you that left ventricle or left part of the heart always having oxygenated blood, and right side of the heart is always having deoxygenated blood. That's why you can understand with the help of this also, oxygenated blood is flowing in aorta. That's why you have to write down in the bracket that is, this is the oxygenated blood, and from the aorta it enter into the body tissues. Body tissues give carbon dioxide. That's why in vena cava there is the deoxygenated blood. Through vena cava, this deoxygenated blood enter into the right side. That's why I have told you that right side is always having deoxygenated blood. This is complete systemic circulation, right? Now next circulation, students. From right auricle, at the time of contraction of right auricle, blood enter into the right ventricle, and from here, from the right ventricle, blood flows through the artery which is known as pulmonary artery. And which type of blood is there in the pulmonary artery? Because here in right auricle, deoxygenated blood is there, right ventricle deoxygenated, and in pulmonary artery also deoxygenated blood is there, which enter into the lungs for the purification. And from the lungs, this carbon dioxide exhaled out and oxygen inhaled, and then it is combined with the hemoglobin. Through hemoglobin of blood, it again enter into the left auricle of the heart through the pulmonary vein. And through pulmonary vein, oxygenated blood enter into the left auricle. This complete circulation is known as, because it is related to the lungs, it is known as pulmonary circulation. So that double circulation is completed in two parts. One is systemic circulation, other is pulmonary circulation. That's it, students. Let us discuss another circulatory medium for the transportation, that is lymph. Lymph is colorless fluid connective tissue. As you know, blood is also a fluid connective tissue, but its composition is almost equal to the plasma, but it is different in plasma, as plasma is yellowish in color and lymph is colorless. Another difference from the plasma is that it does not contain any RBC or platelets, but few form of WBCs are present in the lymph as lymphocytes. As compared to plasma, lymph contains less amount of proteins. Now let us understand where lymph is present and what is it. See, with the help of diagram, I will explain you. This is blood circulating in the blood capillaries. I have shown you blood capillaries thin, which are having thinnest wall, through which easiest diffusion of gases and other nutrients takes place, and these blood capillaries reach to each and every cell and tissues. In between the tissues and the blood capillaries, there is a circulatory medium, fluid material, which is always present, called as, because it is present outside the cells and also present inside the spaces of these cells, that's why it is called as ECF, that is extracellular fluid. And this extracellular fluid, students, is actually lymph, which we are talking about. That means lymph is present in between the cells space, or we can say the space which is present all around the tissues. Now, whatever the material is going to diffuse from the blood to the tissues or to the cells as oxygen, or we can say nutrients, glucose, such as glucose, salts, proteins. When these materials are going to diffuse from the blood into the tissues or cells, they came across our fluid material, which is known as lymph. That's why some amount of plasma, proteins or blood cells escape into the intercellular spaces, which are present here around the tissues or in between the cells, through the pores which are present in the blood capillaries. Some of the protein molecules which are having larger molecular weight remain in the lymph, which are not able to enter through the cell membrane of the cells or tissues. So this material which is passing from the blood to the tissues escape, some of the material escape down into the in between the fluid, in extracellular fluid, form lymph. Now you are clear about it, that lymph composition is having some of the proteins are there, some of the other nutrients are there, some of the plasma content are there, and also lymphocytes are present in the lymph, which provide immunity, which are the form of one of the WBCs, fight against the foreign, we can say, antigens or engulf microorganisms. Now, what happened to this lymph? You have to understand that this lymph, which is also called as extracellular fluid, finally collected through lymph capillaries, which form a different type of circulatory medium known as lymphatic system. There is a different transport system, we can say lymphatic system, in our body, which collect all the lymph through the lymph capillaries, minute lymph capillaries, which join again to form lymphatic, large lymphatic vessels. These lymphatic vessels collect all this lymph and finally drain this lymph into the vena cava, which are the larger veins. And as you know, students, through vena cava, all this material, blood and the lymph, goes into the heart finally. So this is the whole flow of lymph, how it is created around the tissues and how it is collected through the lymph capillaries and then to lymphatic vessels and then to the vena cava and then to the heart. Now come to the functions point wise. Very simple functions are there. As you know, lymph is acting as a middleman between the tissues or cells and the blood. That's why first function, we can say that it helps in exchange of various material between blood and the body tissues, right? Now, second is,
It destroys microorganisms. How? With the help of lymphocytes, which are present in the lymph. Third function is it absorbs fat from the intestine and transport them to the blood. This is all about lymph, students, and keep update yourself. Thank you.